Beloved, we thank God for the torrents of wisdom and revelation He's given to us this week. I begin that way because the Lord said to us recently that we don't thank Him enough for all the wonderful things He's done for us right here at Resurrection House for All Nations. I'm asking you, have you learned to thank the Lord for all the blessings you received? I know you say you're grateful, but He wants to hear you say thank you. Yes, He wants to hear you testify, of His goodness in your life. He wants to hear you say it and appreciate Him from your heart. Those are some of the things that bring the blindness. That will lead me into next week. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for revealing that to me just then. You see, that is a practical demonstration of what I've been ministering all week long. That when you're in that realm, information is constantly downloaded. I do all these things by the Holy Spirit. I have 1,001 things to do, and I'm going from one to another to another to another, and I'm not doing any of it by my might or by my strength. It's by this unction. God keeps downloading wisdom, information in my life. Let's read the text as we conclude so we learn something before we go. This I say, therefore, Ephesians 4 verse 17. We're talking about manifesting or releasing the Zoe life of God in you. This I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord that you henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their mind, having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart. That's where we were yesterday. Your heart has eyes, your heart has ears to hear. That's why Jesus said, he that hath an ear to hear, let him hear. It is the ear of the Spirit. He speaks to us right here. Some people say down here that that's where spirit man is looking. It doesn't matter where you hear. The spirit should be able to minister to you, to govern you, to move you, to, I don't want to say oscillate you, because oscillation, it's almost like a swing from one pendulum to another. No, it is God motivating and actuating you and directing you. That's what it's all about. Now, think about it. Have you considered yourself ignorant and yet you're so smart? But it says if you can hear God, if the wisdom of God is not being downloaded into your spirit, it's because of ignorance. It's because of ignorance. And God wants that ignorance removed from you. I have diagnosed this whole thing. But we need to begin to look at solutions before I leave today. Because in James 1, it says, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask of God that giveth to all men liberally and upbraid it not, and it shall be given him. But watch this. If your mind is not renewed, when the wisdom of God is downloaded, you will reject it. It will make no sense to you. Yes, because they come so simply. I keep saying that. Throw the trash out. And then you say, well, I'm all dressed and I'm late for a meeting. I don't have time to clean up this kitchen and throw the trash out. So you don't do it. You cut yourself off from all the Zoe life of God will manifest through the day. This is what's happening. That's why the enemy is defeating us. And we are not getting what we need from the Lord. Because when the mind is not renewed, you will reject the wisdom of God. How would you want to be like Gideon? You are facing an army of probably 300,000, 400,000, 500,000. And God said, I want you to go with only 300. And even at that, you won't carry any shield or sword or bow or anything. You just need to carry a trumpet and a lamp that you will break at a certain point and blow the trumpet. That's all you need to do. If your mind is not renewed, you will not receive such a solution. Don't you see all the stress that Gideon was under? All the confirmation and double and triple confirmation. And yet he couldn't overcome the fear. The fear was tremendous. God downsized his army to 300. And the only way he could overcome the fear was God said, now, take your servant and go to the camp of the enemy. And there you will hear my word. And then when he heard the man give a dream, and his fellow interpreted it, and the dream indicated that a piece of bread came into the camp of Midian and knocked the tent down and ended up knocking the whole camp down. They said, this is nothing but the sword of Gideon. Even the enemy acknowledged by revelation that Gideon couldn't process because his mind wasn't renewed. And that helped him come to conviction. To know that God has delivered him. That's what happens to us. When that ignorance is in you, you are alienated from the life of God. Your understanding is darkened. Beloved, it's such a tragic place. You walk around like a blind man. You notice when a man is blind physically, he keeps running into things. He has to keep feeling his way. So we live by our feelings and our emotions. And we miss so much. I'm telling you, I regret all the years I wasted fasting and praying and won't listen to God. And then rejecting solutions that come to me. I did. So no, that can't be right. Some of them I didn't like it. And a lot of them today I don't like. But I've learned my lesson, so I just obey. And I'm amazed at the miracles that follow. What has happened to you? Have you learned to do this? Remember that they that are led of the Spirit, they are the sons of God. Next week, we'll be diagnosing further how this blindness occurs. What causes it? You know, you can study ahead. We'll be going to Romans 1. We'll be studying Corinthians. There are so many things the Holy Spirit is just downloading to me. See, that's what I'm telling you. He just downloads. I just know what to do to help you get to your destiny. I pray that this word has reached your heart this week and that you will make a quality decision to obey the Lord. Or if you cannot hear him, then know that there's a reason. Your mind is not renewed. That you need to get in the word and receive transformation. Read it until you are changed. In Jesus' name, love you. God bless you. See you next week. Bye-bye.